Thanks be to God for directing my eye to the place where it lay. Oh, sinful sleep. Now I must walk without the sun. Darkness must cover the path of my feet. Now also I remember how Mistrust and Timorous were frighted with the sight of the lions. These beasts range in the night for their prey. And if they should meet with me in the dark, how should I shift them?
Thy strength so small? Fear not the lions, for they are chained, and are placed there for trial of faith where it is, and for discovery of those that had none. Keep in the midst of the path, and no hurt shall come to thee.
What house is this? And may I lodge here tonight?
This house was built by the Lord of the Hill. And he built it for the relief and security of pilgrims. I am Watchful, the porter. Whence come you, and whither are you going?
I am going to Mount Zion. But because the sun is now set, I desire, if I may, to lodge here tonight.
What is your name?
My name is Christian.
But how doth it happen that you come so late? The sun is set.
I had been here sooner, but that I slept in the arbor which stands upon the hillside. Nay, I had, notwithstanding that, been here much sooner, but that I lost my evidence and came without it to the brow of the hill, and then feeling for it and finding it not, I was forced to go back to the place where I slept my sleep, where I found it, and now I am come.
Well, I will call out one of the virgins of this place, who will, if she likes your talk, bring you in to the rest of the family, according to the rules of the house. Discretion. This man is in a journey from the city of destruction to Mount Zion. But being weary and benighted, he asked me if he might lodge here tonight. So I told him I would call for thee, who, after discourse had with him, mayest do as seemeth thee good, even according to the law of the house.
What is thy name?
It is Christian, and I have so much the more desire to lodge here tonight.
I will call forth two or three more of my family. Prudence, piety, charity.
Come in, thou blessed of the Lord. This house was built by the Lord of the Hill on purpose to entertain such pilgrims in.
Sight of all that fair countryside under the setting sun rests my eye.
Come, good Christian, since we have been so loving to you to receive you in our house this night, let us, if perhaps we may better ourselves thereby, talk with you of all things that have happened to you in your pilgrimage.
With a very good will, and I am glad you are so well disposed.
What moved you at first to betake yourself to a pilgrim's life?
I was driven out of my native country by a dreadful sound that was in mine ears, to wit, that unavoidable destruction did attend me if I abode in that place where I was. I did not know whither to go. But by chance there came a man, even to me as I was trembling and weeping, whose name was Evangelist. And he directed me to the wicket gate, which else I would never have found, and so set me in the way that has led me directly to this house.
Have you a family?
I have a wife and four small children.
And why did you not bring them along with you?
Oh, how willingly would I have done it. But they were all of them utterly averse to my going on pilgrimage.
But you should have talked to them and have endeavored to have shown them the danger of being behind.
So I did. And told them also what God had shown to me of the destruction of our city. But I seemed to them as one that mocked, and they believed me not.
And did you pray to God that he would bless your counsel to them?
Yes, and that with much affection. For you must think that my wife and poor children were very dear unto me.
But did you tell them of your sorrow and fear of destruction?
Yes, over and over and over. But all was not sufficient to prevail with them to come with me.
But what could they say for themselves? Why they came not?
Why, my wife was afraid of losing this world. And my children were given to the foolish delights of youth. So, what by one thing and what by another, they left me to wander in this manner alone.
But did you not, with your vain life, damp all that you by words used by way of persuasion to bring them away with you?
Indeed, I cannot commend my life. Yet this I can say, I was very wary of giving them occasion by any unseemly action to make them averse to going on pilgrimage. Yea, for this very thing, they would tell me I was too precise, and that I denied myself of things for their sakes, in which they saw no evil.
Indeed, Cain hated his brother because his own works were evil, and his brother's righteous. And if thy wife and children have been offended with thee for this, they show themselves to be implacable to good, and thou hast delivered thy soul from their blood.
Supper is ready. Let us sit down to meat.
The Lord of this hill, who built this house for the relief and security of pilgrims, was a great warrior, and hath fought with and slain him that hath the power of death,
but not without great danger to himself, which made me love him the more.
He did it with much loss of blood. But that which put glory and grace into all he did was that he did it out of pure love to his country.
He is such a lover of poor pilgrims that there is not his like to be found from east to the west. Moreover, he hath stripped himself of his glory that he might do this for the poor.
And he hath made many pilgrims princes, though by nature they were beggars born, and their original had been the dunghill.
The south. At a great distance are the Delectable Mountains.
It is a most pleasant country, beautified with woods, vineyards, fruits of all sorts, flowers also, with springs and fountains very delectable to behold.
As this hill for all pilgrims,
and when thou comest there, thou mayest see to the gate of the celestial city, as the shepherds that live there will make appear.
Where am I now? Is this the love and care of Jesus for the men that pilgrims are, thus to provide that I should be forgiven and dwell already the next door to heaven?
Thus have we discoursed together till late at night. Let us commit ourselves to the Lord for protection and betake ourselves to rest.
And before thou settest forward, we will go to the armory for such furniture as the Lord hath provided for pilgrims.
There shalt thou be harnessed with what is proof, lest thou meet with assaults in the way. And now, O pilgrim, thou shalt lie in a large upper chamber whose window opens towards the sun rising.
And the name of the chamber is